Once again, welcome to Ceiven Digital Marketing Training Institute. In Ceiven, teaching you is our ultimate goal. We are still on programming. Today, we want to talk about HTML. I don't like wasting time because I will take you bit by bit. I will hold you by the hand and show you how to code with HTML. Now, I've told you how to install VS Code. If you missed my lecture on VS Code installation, please go back to it. It's on my YouTube. Search it and watch it and learn how to install VS Code. You know why? So I'm going to use VS Code as our test editor. Though there are so many test editors that you can use. So many. When I say so many, yeah, I mean so many. But there are some that are simpler. And normally, since what we are going to do in HTML is not that difficult, it involves a simpler test edit. But I want you to master VS Code. Maybe as the lesson progress, you understand why I want to master VS Code. So without wasting time, too much ado, work with me using VS Code. But don't forget, you can actually use Notepad++, you can actually use Atom, you can actually use, there are so many of them that you can actually lay your hand on and use if you actually want to use them. But me, I want to prefer VS Code. But still, don't follow me if you don't want to. It's your world, it's your right. So any code that's suitable for you, please use. Sometimes people ask me that which test edit is the best. And I always tell them that there's nothing like best test edit. Anyone that works for you, anyone that's very simple for you, kindly use it. Use it. That is what matters. So long as you are using it and it's working for you. Okay? So don't let people bore you with a Atom is the best, the Sublime test is the best, or Blanket is the best, or Notepad is the best, or Test Edit is the best. No. We have so many that are done by different programmers. You know that is good for you, use. But as for me, we want to start with VS Code. So what means I take my mouse, what my mouse is going to see it, VS Code. It's my mouse, yes, this is VS Code. Now what you do is, do it with me. Open your laptop, go to your desktop, right click on your desktop. When you're right on a desktop, go to new. Under new, go to folder. Click on the folder. On that folder, write the name you want to use for your website. Let's do as if you are building a website now. Okay? From this, I will teach you the basic HTML, and then we'll progress to intermediate HTML and then to advanced HTML. I tell you, if you follow me, you're going to learn greatly. You're going to learn so many things. So, since we are going to focus on web design HTML, let's start with, let me write Ceiven theme or Ceiven web. Ceiven web. You can actually save it to whatever you like. You can use any name to save it, doesn't really matter. But I personally prefer Ceiven web. Okay, or Ceiven website. Okay, let me just complete it. Ceiven website. Because some may start asking me that, what's the meaning of web? I know all of us know it, so nobody asked me that kind of question, right? Thank you, my brothers and sisters. Thank you for listening to me. It's my pleasure teaching you this. Okay, so click once and then you save it, Ceiven website. Now click on your VS Code, double click, and VS Code will open. Look at it, VS Code has opened. Now I've opened VS Code, let me make it bold so you can see what I'm talking about. Yes, it has opened. Now let me clear this because I'm going to take it all over from beginning. I need to see it from beginning. So come to file, email open. Go to file. In file, go to open folder. Okay, open folder. If you are using Windows, you can actually press Ctrl plus K, Ctrl plus O, and it will still open the folder. If you're on Windows, if you're on Mac, it's also different, but you can actually open it using shortcut. But if you don't want to use shortcut, just go to file, from file, open folder. Click on it, and you open the folder. Go to your desktop, click on desktop, so I'm going. Click on desktop. From desktop, you see my Ceiven website. Click on Ceiven website, and then the folder is select the folder. And say, do you want to save the changes you made to index.html? No, don't save. Don't save. Just open this new one. You now ask you, do you trust the authors of the file in this folder? Just simply click yes. Yes, there's no problem. You don't need to fear anything. We are here to teach you. Yes, it's a learning process. Okay, so you don't need to fear. Nobody's here to do anything. So right there on your Ceiven website, you now, when you take your mouse, you see it's your mouse turned to hand at Ceiven website, right there in VS Code. Now trace it like that, trace it, go to the first point. What do you see there? When they explore, say new file. Go to the next one, what do you see say? You say the next one says new folder. If you want to create a folder, you use that. Want to create a file, you use that. Remember, there's already a folder, Ceiven website is a folder. So you want to create more folder, you can go for folder. Then the third one is to refresh your explorer, okay? Refresh your explorer, and lastly, you want to collapse all, you collapse all, click on it to collapse, and you can also click on it back and to collapse, okay? So without wasting time, let's go to the first plus, add a file. On this file, don't make sure you type it index.html, index.html. Remember, I told you HTML is hypertext markup language. And let me give you one tip, my brothers. The first thing about programming is being Google wise. You have to love Google, because most of the things Google will teach you. So if you have any problem, if you have any difficulty for you to follow me up, just go to Google, ask Google whatever question you want to show you. But don't worry, I'll be showing you what question you can ask Google, and Google will help you to do this thing. So now this, if you open the first page, number one, index.html one. Now, for you to start working on HTML, there's what we call doc type, just like telling you the document type, okay? You can type it your hand, doc type, HTML, you close it, but if you don't want to close it, simply use your less than and greater than. Open it like that. But I want to also use a quick way, and that is the beauty of using VS Code. VS Code will show you how sharp you can do it. And to do that, just simply press Shift. And you press enter, and then you select the second one, press enter. That's open. So I will explain them now. I will explain everything that has opened now. Index.html is the file we are using right now. Now the doc type is HTML, simply saying that we want to write a program on HTML. Then HTML has a language. You can use any language, can be Chinese, can be French, can be any country you can think of. But I'm teaching in English, so I'm gonna use English. So HTML lang, start from language, equals to English. And don't forget, this is the quote. This is the quote I'm talking about. This, you see it less than, and you end with it greater than. Now you can now quote less than, end with greater than. Then here you are open another syntax. When you open it, you say language equals to semicolon AN, English. So these are things that are very, very important. Don't worry, I will teach you them as we progress. So you know, you understand this thing very well. Just give me some time, let's continue first. Now, meta-chasset. Meta-chasset is UTF-8. Meta is just like description. You want to describe your website. The language of your website is UTF-8. So anybody can actually go to their website, use that language, and get in touch. So you save it again, I'll continue again. So what we do is save, sorry. Just been talking since, but now we are through with the head aspect of it. Well, there are still many things we are going to include there, but don't worry, don't rush. We'll teach you one after the other. I'm talking about the H1. Let me remove this that I wrote so I understand it very well. H1. And what I said is that, let me remove this one first. Now, for H1, it says that in HTML, it's what we call heading. Okay? Heading. I told you that this heading is 6. We have heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, heading 5, heading 6. The heading, just like the way you type when you are writing something in a paragraph, the first heading is bigger, the subheading is smaller, just like that. That's how heading is in HTML. So your heading will help you to know the topic, the title, the subtopic, and all that. Okay. Now do you write heading? I say first of all, what you do is you hold down your shift key. Hold down your shift key. Are you holding that right now? Hold down your shift key. Then press less than on your laptop. Less than. I tell you, when you press less than, is the beauty of VS Code. This will help you to complete it for you. If you actually want it to complete for you, it will complete it for you. If you don't want to complete for you, you can write it on your own hand. Okay? Talking about heading, so you release your shift key. Then you type H1. H1 simply means heading 1. Okay, then you close it again, hold your shift key again, and then this one, press greater than. Press what? Greater than. Now, you notice something? Well, I press greater than here, VS Code completed for me here. So what is this? This is a complete syntax. Greater, less than H1, greater than, close it. Then for you to close your statement that you're making, you can write less than, put underscore or slash, put your slash, H1, close it. But why I want to use VS Code, that VS Code will help you to close it for you. That's the beauty of VS Code. So here, let's type our first sales. Let me say, this is our first heading. This is our first heading. This is our first heading. I call it heading one. Okay, this is our first heading. As usual, save it. Nice heading one. I want us to continue. Let's do this heading two, heading three, heading four. Let's do it together. So what I'll do, I just copy, but you don't copy, do the exactly what I do. I told you what I did, right? What I did is was that I hold down my shift key, press the less than button, right? H1, close that, hold the shift key again, and press greater than button. Then when I do that, and VS Code will complete the remaining last leg for me, which is to hold down your shift key again, press less than button, put your slash, and write H1 and end it, which is this, okay? Then now become a complete syntax, okay? Are you getting it? So let's complete it to heading one, heading two, heading three, and all that. So I'll just copy and paste, okay? Okay. 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 One, two, three, four, five, 6, yes. So change it to heading. There will be heading one, heading two, heading three. So this one will be heading two. And you come over here, heading two. Come over here, change it to heading two. Heading two. There will be heading three. Heading three. Come over here, change it to heading three. Just follow me because I want you to see the heading, the big one, the small one, and all that. Heading three. Don't worry, don't think that we are not moving at a very quiet speed. If you know this one, no problem. Just follow us. If you want to skip and go to the next one, no problem. But better if you decide, get everything. Heading 3. Now, this is heading 4. Come over here. Make it heading 4. Come over here. This is heading 5. Make it heading 5. Come over here. Heading 5. Make it heading 5. And lastly, heading 6. Yeah, make it heading 6, okay? Heading 6, okay? As usual, save your work. Now let's go and see if what you're doing is correct, if you're actually doing the right thing. So as usual, do the same thing we do. You bring your mouse down, come over here, press enter. If it didn't work, no problem, because we're not yet using the VS Code online website, online. So there's what's called live server, not using it yet. Let's just read this first. So you also come over, right click as usual, click on open. To open, you come over here again, right click as usual, open with VR with Google Chrome. You can open with Google Chrome. If you open Google Chrome, yes, the ATM is supposed to open Google Chrome, that's for sure. There's the HTML. Let's see if what we did is correct. If all this way is supposed to work without giving us any problem at all. You have heading 1, heading 2, heading 3. The new heading is compared to heading 6, right? To heading 6. Everything is okay. 17 is there. And let's save it. Let me use Ctrl S. Use Ctrl S. Sometimes this saving may not work with to use Ctrl S, okay, to save it. Now that we save it, let's now come back and do the same thing. Okay. After saving it, come back and do the same thing. Come back here. And do the same thing as well. Same thing like this.
yes, whether we can open with Google Chrome.
Very strong. Sorry, I didn't save it well before. You need to save. So you have to be sure that you save your work, okay? Do you notice something? This is our first heading. Very good. See heading two. This is our first heading. This is our first heading. Can you introduce our first heading, our second heading, third heading, fourth heading, fifth heading, and sixth heading? You know, like you have your heading, topic, your subheading, and all that, okay? So today you've learned this, right? You're going to progress. You're going to progress. There's progress. So let's continue. Well, meanwhile, I don't want you to rush this program. So please, I would like you to go back over this, redo it again, open the folder, create a folder, and do your first heading, and then see what comes of it. I mean, so that you get what I get. If you're able to get what I get, then see you in the next class. Ceiven team cares for you. Our duty is to teach you in the best possible way, in the simplest way that you can master coding or call it programming. Please feel free to subscribe, like, comment, ask us questions, bring more suggestions. We are believing criticism to can improve. Teach, all of us are learning. Teach us, you have anything to bring. Thank you once again for being there for me. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you in the next class.